Hi, I'm Dr. Junaid Hassan. I'm a GP in Bradford and I'm also sitting on the City CCG as the lead for diabetes. Ramadan begins this week and like myself, there's going to be a lot of Muslims that are fasting. This is when you don't eat or drink anything between sunrise and sunset, which can be up to 17 hours this year. Ramadan can pose a challenge to the health of patients with diabetes and other long-term health conditions. Most patients with diabetes should be okay fasting. However, there's certain patients that are higher risk with diabetes. For example, those patients that are taking insulin or those patients that have other health conditions like heart disease or asthma. For these particular patients, it would be sensible to get advice from a health professional before fasting, just in case there's any changes to their medications that are needed. So everyone should be looking after themselves during Ramadan, but particularly those diabetic patients. Everyone can take a few simple steps to improve their diet and lifestyle during Ramadan. For example, when they're breaking their fast, it's important to have small portion sizes rather than overdoing it. Certain people look forward to sort of more fatty foods like samosas, like myself, but it's actually more important to have slower burning foods like basmati rice. And the other thing is just to avoid more sweet and fatty foods if you can. During Ramadan, we know that diabetic patients can be at a higher risk of hypoglycemias, also known as hypos. So we recommend that patients monitor their blood sugars more regularly during the day. If you feel like you are getting signs of hypos, it's important to seek urgent medical attention. With all of the advice given today, we'd like to reiterate that fasting is a personal choice and that if you have any further queries, you can speak to your healthcare professional team or your imam. We wish you a blessed Ramadan.